While prosecutor Marcia Clark has been trying to convince a jury that O.J. Simpson is guilty of murder, she's also trying to convince a judge that she should keep custody of her sons. Should she have to choose between keeping her job or keeping her children?
The story of Selena reads like a rags-to-riches tale. At the tender age of 8, Selena had already realized her dream to perform in front of an audience. Born with the gift of a God-given voice, Selena became the lead singer of the family band, which was assembled by her father, Abraham, and included her brother and sister. Selena's family took to the road in hopes of realizing the dream of superstardom. They could have never imagined what was to come. It didn't take long for the world to embrace the young singer, who captivated audiences not only with her voice, but with her beauty and spirit. There was this magical quality about Selena. Audiences were just mesmerized by her. I could fall in love. Then one day, the music stopped. And at the age of 23, Selena's rising star tragically fell. Selena was gone. The circumstances surrounding her death leave us without answers, but her life has since become a symbol of hope, inspiration, and attaining the American dream. The memory of Selena lives on. In this hour of LEEZA, we'll pay tribute to this young talent and meet the remarkable cast of the movie Selena. And all of my audience has seen the film, just now got out, right? Did you love it? Yeah! This movie not only celebrates her life, but also her musical legacy. And we'll talk to Selena's real-life dad. So, our focus today, Selena, A Life Cut Short. Please come on back and join us. Very moved by the performances of my guests today and feel that they all really embrace that magical quality that we talk about with Selena through the movie. I want you to welcome three of the cast members we're starting out with. First of all, the oh-so-beautiful actress who portrayed Selena, Jennifer Lopez, is here. And the actress who played Abraham and Marcella Quintanilla, Edward James Olmos. And Constance Marie. I'm so glad you're here. Welcome. Now, you guys have seen the movie, and Edward, you haven't even seen it yet.
No, I haven't.
You're in for a treat, don't you think, guys?
Yeah.
Let's start out with the big spotlight on Selena. Talk about pressure for an actress. First of all, great role, but did you feel a tremendous amount of heat?
At first, yeah, I did, because I'd never gotten a role where I had to do a press conference, and everybody wanted to know that I got who got the role. You know, it kind of had that Scarlett O'Hara feel to it. It was huge, and I didn't really realize the whole phenomenon of Selena before I started researching the character. But once I did get it, I realized that I couldn't focus on that I really had to. I had a big job, like you said. It's a huge role. There's so many things that go along with playing somebody, let alone playing a character, let alone somebody who was actually alive 2 years ago and who people remember.
Alive and loved, and the Selena fans are so passionate about her. You said that when you first got cast, they would swarm to you and share their stories with you.
Oh, yeah. One of the great things about doing the part was I actually got to meet a lot of Selena's fans, and so many came out. I mean, we had 33,000 people come out for the reenactment of the Houston Astrodome down in San Antonio. And that day, you know, people would always come up to me and tell me stories and why Selena was so important to them and what she did for them and how she inspired them. And it just really made me feel what it was like to be her and why her fans were so important to her, the most important thing to her.
She had this, and audience, tell me how you felt about it. And I know a lot of you are Selena fans. She had this, like, innocent sexuality. There was this duality that existed within her. I mean, she had the moves like nobody's business. And you are a trained dancer and singer in your own right.
Right.
But your natural instinct wasn't to move like Selena.
No, I mean, everybody moves different, you know? So when you go to move like somebody else and you videotape yourself and you realize, I don't look anything like her. I don't move like her. I don't talk like her. What am I going to do? And it was just, I thought the dancing would be the easiest thing and really turned out to be just as hard as everything else.
There was some major hip swiveling going on. major, wasn't it? You know, I know that her dad, whose character you portray, was he was an executive producer on this film, right?
Yes, he was.
And this was really such a personal project and his love letter to his daughter. Did you spend a lot of time with him and with the family?
Yeah, we all did. We spent as much time as was humanly possible. It was the hardest film to date that I've ever participated in, bar none.
Not only a hard film, but when we come back, Edward James Olmos will explain why you feel this is one of the most important films that you've done as well. And later on, we're going to talk to Selena's father and find out why on some days the eerie resemblance between Jennifer Lopez and Selena made it difficult for him on the set. See you back here. Stay close.
Reloj, no marques las horas, porque voy a enloquecer. That means, clock, don't mark the hours, because I'm going nuts.
Clock, don't mark the hours, because you're going nuts?
I know, it sounds a little weird in English, but...
Dad, what's this all about?
This is about learning to sing in Spanish, right?
Dad, I don't want to sing in Spanish. I don't even like music in Spanish. I like Donna Summer.
In fact, the real life Selena didn't even learn to speak Spanish. We're talking with the cast of the movie today, which our audience has just seen. And you had a question, darling?
How did you discover the little girl who plays Selena? The younger one.
The one we just saw. How was she discovered, guys?
Well, they had a big open call. I mean, the part of Selena, both parts were open to everybody, not just professional actresses. So they had a big open call in 5 cities, I think. And everybody could come down and audition, and that's where they found Becky Lee. Becky Lee is actually from Harlingen, Texas.
There was actually controversy. We talked about the spotlight on your role, but there was the community was divided a little bit over the fact that Selena was Mexican American, and are you Puerto Rican American?
I'm Puerto Rican. Yeah.
And people were concerned about that.
Yeah, I guess at first, but you know, I think the press kind of blew that up out of proportion. It wasn't as bad as it seemed. I think it was a few people picketing outside.
Two guys out there.
Out of the production
office. Became a big headline story.
Oh, yeah. You know,
it's funny how that happens, isn't it?
Yes, I'd like to ask Jennifer and also Edward, how much weight did you have to gain for the movie? And was it easier to lose the weight or gain the weight?
What are you saying? I look fat in the movie? Hold on.
I'll let Jennifer answer her. No, she gained no weight.
I gained no weight.
Okay.
I may look thinner in person, but that's because the screen puts a few pounds on you, but that's all me up there.
I thought you two were a little more healthier, you know? Especially Edward.
Edward, you did, didn't you?
I did, yes. I went up to 220 pounds. I'm at 185.
Yeah.
I came back down now. I'm still about, I don't know, maybe 20 pounds still overweight. But
apparently it was such an effective transformation, though, that people would mistake you for Abraham on the set.
Well, you know, if you hang around each other long enough, you'll start to look like each other in some ways.
And, it's kind of like people and their dogs, huh?
Same thing. We had such a good time at the Hi Ho eating.
Oh, God.
The Hi Ho is a restaurant in Corpus Christi, and we just had a good time. Just we would talk about life and everything else while we ate. And we ate and we ate.
All the good stuff.
Didn't do one bit of exercise and gained 60 pounds.
Just loving life.
He had a ball, in other words.
Not only did he physically resemble Abraham Quintanilla, but he also really embodied, from what I have been told about this gentleman, and we'll meet him in a little bit, embodied his drive and his passion and his
fiery spirit. Watch this scene.
What is she wearing? She's practically got nothing on. She's in her bra.
Abraham, it's not just her bra. It's one of those things, you know, like all the girls are wearing.
Marcella, she can't be wearing things like that. There are men out here.
It's a bustier.
Bustiquela, that's her bra. Look at it.
I think she looks cute.
Shocked to see that the mom looks like this in real life.
I mean, you when you were the young version of mom, you were like a hot babe.
I tried.
But it's like you're so young and beautiful, they didn't know whether to cast you as Selena or as the mom.
I'm just very flexible as an actress.
No problem. Her character was like the one who kept it all together, kind of nurturing, pleasing the dad, pleasing mm-hmm. the kids. Mm-hmm. And she was conspiring with Selena on that bustier.
Just a little bit, I think, yes.
Well,
she helped her. She helped her make it in a hotel room at like 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock in the morning, because Selena always waited till the last minute to make her costumes. And they would go with the glue gun and the bra and like totally glue it together and have no sleep and then show up and look fabulous the next day.
It was such a beautiful film. She would be very proud, I think, of all three of you. Do you think this will open up a lot of doors for Hispanic actors?
Certainly.
Especially at Academy Awards time?
Well, you said you thought it was an important movie. Why so?
Well, I think that what it does is it allows people to experience the American dream. Anytime you get uplift the human spirit using the arts, it's a triumph. Forrest Gump. We don't see enough of these kind of movies, and this is one of those kind of movies that literally you can take. An 18 or 25-year-old or a 3-year-old or a 4-year-old or an 89 or 90-year-old person to see this film, and everyone's going to come out really feeling great. It's a tragic, it's the American dream meets the American tragedy. Now, as far as the Hispanic situation, the Latino situation, yeah, I think that this will probably make the entire door swing wide open. Selena had given us a great opportunity. She was the single most important factor in opening some of the most extraordinary doors between the United States and Latin America of any single artist in the history of the American culture. She was an American, born and raised here, and she went to Latin America and swept Latin America, then came back by way of Latin America to the United States as if she were a Latin American star. And then she came here, and everybody here just fell in love with her, thinking that she was from there, but she was really... She has a great scene where she says, and it happened, she says, you know, everybody's going to wonder how I learned English so quickly.
Coming up next, our guest will share what it was like to portray the one man that nobody wanted for Selena, but ironically, this is the person who became the love of her life. We'll meet him right after this. Stay close. Songs that Selena recorded, but also one of the first English-speaking songs. The album went to number one just after her death, and ironically, that was the beginning of the crossover career that Selena did not live to enjoy. My next guest portrays the man who not only captured the heart of Selena, but won her family over against all odds, and also the actress who portrays Selena's sister and really best friend. Please welcome John Seda and Jackie Guerra. Guerra!
Pronounce your name, Jackie.
My continent. Guerra.
Guerra.
There you go.
I'm not so good at the R. At the R rolling.
Suddenly, I'm Czechoslovakian.
No, I was doing my Texas twang. How y'all doing?
Great.
Good. It's really good to have you here. The audience, I have to tell on you, when John came out, went crazy. There's a high degree of testosterone happening here on the stage, and they are appreciating you.
That's cool.
You had a... You had a pivotal role in this movie because you were like a rebel who came into the band, this real hot guitarist, Chris Perez, and fell in love with Selena, and this was not a real popular thing.
Yeah. Chris is he's an amazing guitarist. I mean, he's probably like the next Santana or something like that. I mean, he's just amazing.
Now, you actually have become really tight with him?